switches. Yeah. Two dial switches above the door. One on the left says ultra store, that's storing your water. The one on the right is ultra heat, that's heating your room. Okay, so that's for the heater. So we've just done the electric, which is the electric switch for your water heater is under the seat. That one is for your gas, so that's off. You can operate water heating on electric and gas at the same time if you want to.
Nice.
Obviously you'll be using your gas rod a bit quicker, but what it will do is use both energies to get up to heat. If you're really desperate for a lot of hot water, then you operate on both. If you're quite happy, you tend to use the site facilities, electric's sufficient enough. And obviously, if you pay for your pitch, electric's
free
as such. So to operate it, all you do is turn the outer ring. You'll see a green light in there. That's if I switch that off, you can probably see a green light.
Yeah.
The green light is indicating that's working. If it goes to red, that means it's failed. Okay. So if it's failed, the reasons are one, you haven't turned your gas on. Two, you haven't got the gas. Three, you haven't taken the cover off. Or four, there may be air in the system. So if it fails, switch it off, check all them things, then the likelihood if all them things are okay, all you need to do is purge the air out of the system. So it will be a matter of turning it on, it may fail again, switch it off. So it might take two or three attempts of that, then it should fire up and remain green.
Got you.
Okay? Yeah. The difference between running on gas and electric is 70 degrees thermostat controlled, so that's you've got no variance on that. On the gas side, you have. So if you just run on gas, can operate on 70 down to 30. Okay.
Yeah.
Happy with that?
Yeah.
Happy with your water heating?
Yeah.
Water system I didn't fully carry on with, but to get the water in, it'll be exactly the same as, you know, getting the air out of the system.
Yeah.
Purging the air out. Filling your hot water tank by using the hot side of your tap and getting the air out of that and filling that up. You're happy how to do that, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, next is your heater.
Yeah.
So what we've got is on that right hand side, you can see there it says 230 volts, so that's electric. That's gas for your water heating, that's electric for your heater, which is your fire.
Yeah.
So the master switch, which was under that bunk for your water heating and electric, you have a master switch for this one, which is cleverly hidden. So I'll show you where it's in. Even though that's not so critical if you do forget to put the switch on, not switch that off. Right, just down here to the right, you'll see a switch which is identical to that. Should have a little
the neon on.
Yeah, so with the light on, that's the one that switches the power on to that switch above the door.
Right.
If that switch is off, which I'll just do now, if you look at the switch above the door now, that little green light will have gone off. So if you're trying to operate it, there's no green light there, there's not going to be any.
It's not
going to be on that. You see, there's no green light?
No.
Hopefully.
Yeah,
no. Yes, no. Right, so that's switched on now. So you should have a green light on that one now.
Yeah.
Yeah, the options are 500, 1000 or 2000 watts, or half a kilowatt, 1 or 2 kilowatts, which is heating an element up behind this fire.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's heating your room. Awesome. Or you've got the gas option. If I switch that off, don't operate both at the same time. So if you've got no electric, obviously you've got to operate on gas.
That's a good idea then, isn't it?
I can't hear the clicking on that. Nope. So he was just changing that battery, but I can't hear the clicking.
I'll switch this off.